Yes. Hello dear friends. In this video, I will continue again about these shipyard recommendations. But at first, I have to explain something. You know, I have already prepared some videos about shipyard recommendations, but they were in Turkish language. Okay. And I, from my previous contracts, I select several photos, and then in the videos I use that photos. After I record, I just erase them, and then it will be very difficult for me to select all the photos, same photos again from my previous contract folders. So, in this videos. I will continue from my Turkish video, but I just switch off the volume. Actually, only the photos are enough. So I will explain from that video record photos. Okay, I am sorry for that. Anyway, we just start. Şimdi in this photo. One of the shipyard. Actually, that photos for the. I am sorry. Just a moment. I am sorry. That photos. The. Before delivery, the orders of the class surveyor to the shipyard. Okay, this is the foundation of the aluminium ladder, pilot aluminium ladder. So when they fix the foundation to the main deck, they didn't put some Dublin plating here. So it is a problem. So when you go to shipyard, please also as much as possible, if you see any problem, you should be you should inform the master or the especially the class surveyor. Okay. So what I mean, when you look at the shipyard, you don't look only, you have to see. When you look, you have to see also. In this is you see the accommodation ladder. This area is not welded Dublin plating. They just weld directly to the main deck. Okay. Yes, this is much more better. You see here, in the cable trunks, in the cable trunks, the cables must not touch each other. Okay, as much as possible has to be separated. You see, when they fix the cables, they just put very close to each other, and some of them at the back touching each other. This is also another important point. Also, this isolation for the fire tight integrity. You see. Has to be completed, so has to be intact. This area must be completely isolated. This area must be closed. So sometimes they forgot to close some part remaining open. So you have to check also this one. Actually, this is for electrician, but anyway, when you go anywhere for any reason, always keep your eyes open, and when you look, you have to see. Okay. Şöyle yapabiliyoruz mu? How can I proceed? Nasıl yapsak? Yes, this is much more better. Full screen is much more better, I think. Yes. Yes, this is another important thing. When you check the letters, okay, this is Manila rope, you know. It can be draft leather, pilot leather, or embarkation leather of the life rafts. Not important. For this Manila ropes, what is important? You see, there is some the rope condition is not very good. You see some small pieces separated. The wires, I will tell wires. Fibres. Yes, much more better. This is natural rope. Fibres separated from the main part. So, how will we evaluate this rope is in good condition? The strength is sufficient or not sufficient? How will you check this one? Şimdi when you see this Manila rope, with just your finger, if you try to, you see these small fibres, if you try to take them, if they are breaking, it means this Manila rope is not good condition. Or maybe you just with your finger, just push strong. If it is separating each other, okay. If it is wasted, so it means it is wasted. But when you try, when you pull, if it is not breaking, no problem. Even if some small fiber wires, no problem. Okay, it is in good condition. So you can check like this. I will show another photos also. Okay. Maybe I can, pardon. It is much more better. You see here, I just try to break the fibre with my fingers. If it is easily coming, very easy. You can take, okay, it is wasted. Or if you push too much with your finger, if it is separating each other, this means the Manila rope is busted. But otherwise, okay, it means still you can use this one. It will be no problem. Yes, we continue. Yes, şimdi especially if you are working in a bulk log carrier. You know timber loading, what I mean. If you are working in a timber vessel, what is important? You see, these are collapsible stanchions. And the other area fixed stanchions. These frames on main deck, this area, because of these collapsible stanchions, okay, not very easy to reach and check. Okay, so, but this area sometimes wasted. Most probably, if your vessel is old, okay, and it is better to you check here. It is wasting, too much rusty, and then start cracking. The frame start cracks here. This area, very very important. You see this frames on the main deck, the in this part. So backside of this collapsible stanchions, this is the frame, the down part. You see the collapsible stanchions going like this, rising here. So it is very difficult to check this backside. Also here on the main deck also. You have to check the condition of this frames connection with the longitudinals. Okay, it is also important point. I will increase the speed much more better. Yes. Yes, you see here. This area. This. The underside, the connection part here also. Especially this part. If this is just little away from the side of the vessel, because this is the pilot walking way, you know, this is the pilot embarkation ladder, aluminium. But the main deck parts very difficult to check. So the backside of this collapsible stanchions, this area especially the connection with the main deck and this area the cable way has to be checked. Don't forget this one. Okay. And this is another important thing. This is the accommodation ladder, alüminyum ladder. So this part has to be working. Because when you down the upper platform, this supporting from the downside. Okay, this is very important. If this is not support, you will easy damage the upper platform. Yes. Şimdi what I want to tell about these aluminium ladders. Okay. Aluminium ladders you have to check very well. Always. Especially before shipyard. Okay. Why? Because this aluminium welding you cannot make at the vessel. Okay. So if you have any problem with the aluminium ladders, it has to be repaired in the shipyard. Okay. It is very important. You cannot make this one at the vessel. So you have to consider this one everywhere of the aluminium you have to check. Okay. This is the step area. You see the step. Also here some deformations, some and these are roller guides. Okay. Şimdi most probably they will tell you, okay, you can make at the vessel, but anyway it is better if you try to make them at the shipyard. It will be much more better. But şimdi my friends, I have made several videos, okay, when I was working at the vessel. But all of them in Turkish language. So I am not working on board now, but what I am planning, same like this video. I will just open my old videos, but I will switch off the volume and I will record them in English language, okay. I am not on board, but previously I have already made one video about this pilot letters before, but it is in Turkish language. Anyway, I will translate all of these videos into English. Okay, but this roller guides very important. You see here some the wire eat the roller guide. What I mean? I will show you, but I cannot show now. Anyway, all because these are becoming rusty and not turning. Okay, this the area I will show in another photo. Where is the wire working? Okay. The roller guides here becoming rusty, not turning. So it is not turning wire easy eating this roller guide. Okay. Also the grease accumulate that area and cover everywhere so you cannot see if the roller guide is damaged or not damaged. Okay. So this is the main shaft of the ladder. You see some small shift. This is important. What does it mean? Maybe some deformation on the shaft or this foundation of the shaft. Maybe some little separated like this. Okay. So, but this is important thing. So, you see there is some gap here. It is just go inside. Most important part is the aluminium ladders. At least you just check this one. And then as much as possible, if any problem, try to push the shipyard. Okay. Speaking with the company. You see, this is the tackle of the aluminium ladder. The wire coming like this, going other side and then going other side down. So, in that area, some small roller guides. How can I say? Just something like this, that just roller guides, the pipe going here, just it is guiding the wire from there with turning. It is normally has to turn with the wire, okay. But because of the rust, it's stuck up, not turning, so wire sawing this roller guide and easy eating here. So also damaging the wire also. Okay, it is important thing. So, if any problem, in case any problem with the ladders, so when they check, they will tell you, you didn't make properly maintenance. So it will be very big headache for you. And then what I recommend you for the lines or wire ropes, not cover with hose, okay. What I recommend you, because if you cover with the hose, it is becoming rusty inside and you cannot check this one, okay. You cannot check the condition of the wire or condition of the rope. So, if it is originally fabricated, it is different. Nothing to do, but not make like this, what I recommend you. Otherwise, after you, it will be long time and nobody will check this one. Even if the wire is becoming very old, becoming damaged, very rusty, or the wires broken, nobody can understand, so it will be very, very big problem. Never. Okay, forget. But what I recommend, it is better just graze very well. If you want just anti-corrosive tape, you can apply. But anyway, only graze is enough. Only graze is enough for instant check. Okay, you see there is a shift also. On the main shaft. You see the manila rope here already finish. You can easily understand. From the fibres of the manila rope here. Also, very important thing I want to talk. You see what happened here. And when I was checking these aluminium ladders on the accommodation, here they just cover with the anti-corrosive tape, okay. But normally, the end of the eye of the wires and the wire coming like this, this is the eye. They just put a thimble here and it is metallically spliced. So this area just very small, bigger, just a little bigger than the original wire. But in here, when I look, it is very, very big area. So I think there is something wrong here. When we open this anti-corrosive tape, you see most probably the wire before damage it. They just cut the wire. So they just make hand splicing with the wire clips here. And then they just leave like this. And this wire clips, the making the eye, it is not good seamanship. You will see the photos. Actually very poor seamanship. Not good. And not safe actually. Anyway, you see this parts has to be very, very good working condition, okay. Has to be very good working condition and has to be moving. So when you lower, so it is supporting the upper platform here by touching the side of the vessel. It is important. Yes. Aldı mı? Aldı. Yes, I am drawing here, okay. So I will show you what is the problem. So, another thing you have to... Okay, it is just draw. Another thing you have to consider the condition of the upper platform. It is very, very important, my friend. So how will you check this one? Okay, this is my aluminium ladder. Okay, this is lower platform, this is upper platform. And this is the supporting. From the main deck, it is going down. You see, there is a main pin here. It is holding the upper platform. Also, it's enabling the ladder, turning the sides. In case of the port, maybe you just little make it away. It is turning from this main pin, okay? So, if any deflection here, on the upper platform. The back side of the upper platform is bigger than the forward side. So what I mean, if this just go like this, so the you see here holding pin. Most probably your upper platform is busted. Okay. So if you take it out the upper platform, you will see all the frames becoming very rusty, and so your upper platform and your ladder is coming down like this. Upper platform will be have some deflection, okay? So it will be not even with the main deck. So it will be go just little go like this. So it mean you have to check your upper platform, okay? Don't forget this one. This is very very important. If the gap, this is the foundation. This is holding the aluminium ladder completely, okay? And the aluminium ladder connected the platform with up the foundation with the upper platform, okay? And upper platform and the foundation connected with the pin. Normally this has to be even, exactly same like this and the main deck. But this upper platform, just this is my foundation, okay? If it is parallel upper platform, it is no problem. But my upper platform becoming like this, have some deflection, not parallel with the foundation. So it mean you have to check some problem here. Very very important, my friend. Don't forget this one. Okay. But why I am telling this one? Because this is very big shop, my friend. If you they can make it repair this one much more easily in the shipyard. We realize one of the vessel this problem. Okay, we make this one, but one ladder, one platform takes 1 week minimum for the fitter. Okay, it is a big job actually. So it is better to you can fabricate. You see what I mean here. This is the foundation. It is going down to main deck, and then this is upper platform. This is the main shaft. You see in the middle. So this upper platform turning with this main shaft. But you see here almost no gap means okay. But here okay, we are on the seaway. So when you lower down, if this gap is increasing too much like this, so it mean this upper platform plating inside wasted, most probably wasted or very poor condition. Even if not wasted, very very poor condition. So it is very important. Okay. You see, this is foundation. This is upper platform. Here is the pin. Yes, this has to be in good working condition to support the platform also. Okay, you see, this is bullshit. You see the bullshit actually. The hand splicing, how, what is the regulations for the hand splicing? What is the good seamanship? This is actually very, very poor. You see, they just cut. They just make the rope like this. They just make the eye going here and by hand with the shackles. Actually, this wire clips also not suitable size also. Also, they are very close to each other. One of looking here, the other here, the other here. Okay, this can also hold the ladder, but if any problem, if anybody see this one, you cannot, your head will be in very big trouble actually. Okay. Don't forget, mechanical supplies is the best. Okay, this is, maybe you can make this one for emergency. Okay, you can continue with this one, but you must be order a new wire and one spare wire also, always. Okay, don't forget, for each ladders, you must have, you not must, but as a good seamanship for emergency something, okay. Just one spare wire much more better, okay? And Suitable size, suitable diameter, suitable length and width mechanical splicing. Not like this. Okay. Yes. You see here. This is somehow damaged. Okay. This is the supporting pieces of the leather. So this is damaged. I will show you. Because when you take the leather in parking position, it is supporting from down to make the leather in proper. But you see, this is not supporting. So leather deflected. You see. Yeah, this is a action cam. Actually, this is extremely in the objective, because of the objective becoming extreme. But I will show you. It is already deflected. The leather like this because not supporting here. You cannot make all of them in the vessel. Okay, it is because it needs aluminium welding. So it's actually shipyard business. Okay. Very important. You see here the supporting point. The leather go too much down this part. Actually, the upper part has to be around this level. So the aluminium leather deflected too much. And then it's go down. You see the distance, how many? Maybe about 8 cm something, 7-8 cm. The leather deflected, bended, and then support point. So it is bended, supporting point becoming up. You can understand also from there, the deflection. So if any pieces like this, so it has to be intact. So when you take the parking position, this area will come here and it will support the leather. It will prevent leather from the deflection. Okay, it is very important also. You see, this Manila rope also wasted actually. Some crack something. Okay, this is pilot access point. What is important with the pilot access point? You see, these are collapsible railings. Okay. This support point of the railings sometimes wasted. Also, this railing itself sometimes wasted. They just put this one. This is collapsible. When you go to navigation, you have to take them out and put to store. When pilot come, just put back. But sometimes they don't make like this. They always keep the railing here, but from the this area inside the supporting point, the railing here becoming very rusty. So when you pull it very strong, it is broken. So you can consider this one. You put the ladder here and then pilot climbing. And then when he take the railing, if it is broken, maybe he will fall to sea. It is very dangerous actually. Always check this one, the down part, the inner part of the railing, okay, this area, because they just live like this and it will be wasted. You see, some deformation, something, several things. Also the other leather, same. We open all of them. Okay, this is the free fall lifeboat. You see, it is not good graced. What was the name? I forgot. Anyway, this rolling part is not greased very well. It's stuck up inside, and then one side going down, one side stay up. And here's some problem I will show you. You see, they just also put some railing, the wire clip here, and this is not mechanical supply. This is very poor condition, very poor seamanship actually. This is the lifting sling. You see, this is the lifting sling of the free fall lifeboat. So it is already the wire already very poor condition. Okay. Normally, because you will go to, if you go 5 yearly special survey to the shipyard, before shipyard, your company will order you to change all the wire on board, most probably. Okay. So in one of the vessel, other than the Bunker David, one of the Bunker David, we didn't change the other, we change also. All the wires on board we change, you know. All the wires, it will take too much time. And it is a serious job actually. Every David, ladder, the provision crane, cargo crane, all the wires we change. And luffing wires we didn't touch. So actually, you know, the luffing wire change much more easy than hoisting wire change. You know, I have already changed three times the luffing wires. Actually, not 3 times. In one of the vessel, yes, 3 of them we change. One of the vessel, 4 of them, maybe 7 times. Yes, I change the luffing wire also. Actually, luffing wire change of the cargo cranes much more easy than the, what was the name? The hoisting wire. Anyway, okay, we just continue. You see, very poor and nobody see by you. Okay, how will you understand the condition of the wire, even if it is rusty? What does it mean? So, if any cracks in the wires, okay, individual wires separate each other, it mean it is problem. This is the upper part. You see here. You see, there is a wire broken already here, small wire. Also here. Okay. So. And what is the, for the other wires, for example, how will you understand? For example, you are working in a bulk log carrier. Okay. Very long time, the vessel didn't load timber cargo. And then they told you, okay, you have a voyage. Please check your equipment. The stocks of the vessel, wires, everything, shackles, everything. And give us a report. So what you need, tell us. So in case, what will you do? My friend, how you can understand if a wire rope in good condition or not? Şimdi not very close breaking, but just keep like this. I want the shoulder, okay, shoulder distance, a wire. If you broke like this, if you turn them like this, when you turn the wire, it is becoming like this. Correct. Ha. If the wires broken when you turn, but if you make it very close, yes, it will be broken. It will be kinked. But just a little long, yeah. You just turn this one. If the wires start breaking, it's mean that wire is wasted. It is garbage. You have to order. But even if rusty, if you just turn, and then there is no breaking wires, and then you can turn also like this, huh? Like this. You just, the camera is difficult. I am going like this. It is going other side. I am sorry. Nasıl? Şöyle. Huh? You just make the wire like this, and if you turn also like this, if the wire is not breaking when you make the wire like this, so it okay, it is in good condition. But if it is start, the individual wire start breaking, okay, it is best. You cannot use this one. Don't forget, okay? You see, this is already wasted. This is lifting sling of the life raft. Very good seamanship, actually. Yes. The rust condition is no problem, but the wires, if broken, very big problem. Don't forget. You see, always check also the down part of the wire. Okay, this is fabricated, coated with the nylon. Nothing to do. Okay. But you see the wires start separate each other. Okay, this is wasted. Anyway, this is the ventilation lower of the hatch cover. And this is the butterfly. And The other part is missing. So we were using ramnek tape here to close this one. When you go to check the cranes, very very careful outside of the cranes especially because you see the railings wasted and most probably all of them will be wasted. And here some I forgot the name actually this part. You know there is a small thing when you put the wire inside the hook, it is automatically close again. So prevent the wire jump from other side of this hook. Okay. So it is missing also. Sometimes if you are going to shipyard, it will be very easy to provide this one. Okay. They can make also. You see the railings very rusty condition. Fitter can make this one, but it will take too much time. You see, this is almost finished. It is garbage. With one fitter, it will take too much time, my friend. You understand what I mean? So it is better in the shipyard. It is the exact time. They can make very quickly this one. You see, completely the vertical rudder shifted. This is I take photos from the bulk log carrier. You see? Pardon. How many minutes? Okay. You see, for that, for example, slings, wire slings. When you make them like this, if it is broken, it is wasted. If it is not broken, okay, you can use this one. You can understand like this also. You see, this is the MacGregor crane. Here is the jump preventer roller here, back. And this is the hoisting drum. I will show the other photos also, okay. And this is the jump preventer, pressure roller. And this pressure roller make pressures with the springs. Correct. It is coming here. There is a bolt and nut. This is very close, you know. And maybe with the vibration, it will turn and it will be released. I will show also the photos. It is releasing. So for the MacGregor cranes, it is a typical problem. Okay, don't forget this one. When you change the wire of the MacGregor crane, this is the limit box. Just completely take out from here. Okay, electrician can make this one. Just completely remove. This is, don't forget, if you not remove the limit box for the hoisting or luffing, no problem. In the MacGregor, it will be very big headache. Don't forget, if you will change the hoisting wire or luffing wire, but let's speak about hoisting wire. If your crane is MacGregor, 100% remove the limit box. Okay. I have already explained the critical points of the crane wire change, but it is Turkish, but I will translate it English. But don't forget, if you not remove and you will not able to make the limit adjustment again in the MacGregor. Don't forget this one. Just before you change, take the position, take photos, make your markings, and then remove the limit box, change the wire, take the drum same position with the same winding of the wire, and then connect again. Okay, the limit box. I will explain in the another video. This is the guider rollers. Okay, for the hoisting and luffing. You see, these are very poor condition. Already saw with the hoisting and luffing wires. Why like this? Also the another typical problem of the MacGregor crane because these are Teflon rollers. Okay. Already Teflon. Actually idea is good, but what is the problem? When pass too much time with the grease mixed with the cargo dust becoming stuck up. Okay. So this Teflon rollers not intact, not one pieces. Okay. It is some small pieces. Several pieces here. By the time when they are running, these grease go inside with the cargo dust and it is becoming stuck up, not turning anymore. Not turning, but the wire still running on of it. So you see here already eat the Teflon roller. So what I recommend you see almost finish. What we did, you see the working area of the wire here. What you can do if you don't have any spare roller, Okay, you just take out this one, take all of them out, clean anything, and then when you are putting back, because the corners will be good condition, because the wire running area is here, not in the corners. In the corner, maybe two or three Teflon roller will be in very good condition. So in this good conditions, you select, put in the middle, very very poor condition. Okay, same like here. Put the corner because wire will never come here. Okay, don't forget. Wire will be just maybe until there maximum. You can see from the, you see this is the exactly corner. We put the very poor condition rollers to the exactly corner because wire when running like this, it is going up, 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 and but it is moving one side to other side. So it will not come to corners. Okay, don't forget. If you don't have any spare, but maybe sometimes even if you have spare, just keep the spare. Yeah, you can use also like this. It will be no problem. Another typical problem of the MacGregor crane. You see, this is the hoisting wire. This is the top sheave group. Huh? Sheave. Yes, the rolling part. I show you in the life raft. The life raft, David. The rolling parts, sheave. This is top sheave group. In the cranes, two sheave groups. Jib sheave group, top sheave group. Correct. This is top sheave group. In the top sheave group, this is the hoisting wire socket of the MacGregor crane. In here, you see there are two bolts here. With the end, you put the socket and then you see here is a metal cover. You put also this one. And then with the two bolts, you tighten it so the hoisting socket cannot go out. But with the vibration, these bolts becoming slackened. So sometimes drop, sometimes one of them drop, one of them still here. Maybe but loosen at least. So every operation or every 2 day during operation, just check this one. This is a typical problem, especially for the hoisting socket. Don't forget. If you wish, okay, each day of the operation, check. If 24 hour working in the port, just check these two bolts, okay. This is forward life raft. Also embarkation ladders, check for the life rafts, okay. You see the condition, you see, you can easily see here what I mean. Yes, pardon. You see, when you take with your finger the body of the rope, if it is broken, means that is finished. You see, it is broken. Just one side is removed. The locking mechanism of the watertight door. You see, this is a fixed tension. In a lock carrier, it is already damaged. And this is the lower platform of the accommodation ladder. On underside of the roval platform, there is a cylinder here. But it is inside completely separated too. Okay, you can check also these parts. Yeah, I am telling all of them, but most probably, most of them, they will not make in the shipyard. Your company will tell you, okay, you just make in the vessel, but don't forget. As much as possible, try to push them to the shipyard. Okay, this is mushroom ventilation. Mushroom ventilation is one important point here. You see, okay, this is the flame mesh. I will not also important, but when you turn the wheel, or maybe sometimes it is with the flap. Okay, there is a flap like this inside. Sometimes wheel turning or the flap lever is turning, but inside the disc is not closing or the flap is not turning, or sometimes the disc or the flap inside wasted, already very rusty. Okay, you are closing, but it is not close the ventilation. Okay, you have to check also this one. If any problem, this is big job you can make in the shipyards. Okay, as much as possible you push, don't forget. In the shipyard, if they not make, you will make later. Don't forget this rule. Okay. You see, very poor condition of the Free fall, wire, lifting sling. You see very very well. You see what I mean is this one. When you take, no need to be all your force. What I mean? Just like this with your two finger. If you can easily broke or when you pull, it is broken, it is finished. Or with your finger if you push and it is separating easily, okay, it means the rope is finished. You see, this is what was the name in the hatch cover, circulation valves. In forward and the, for example, in five hold bulk carrier vessel, beside the hold number one and hold number five, okay, şöyle nasıl, şöyle, two circulation valves. What is the on the main deck, on the main hydraulic line of the hatch covers? What is the purpose of this one? This one. These valves, I have already see two kind of these. On sometimes only one valve beside hold number five or hold number one. Sometimes I already with two valves. One in hold number five, one in hold number one. So, in cold climate, when you go and you drop anchor, you are waiting for the berthing. So, if the weather is very cold, you have to circulate the hydraulic oil. So, these valves are normally open. Don't forget. Okay, normally closed. Pardon. It is normally closed. But in cold climates, you open them and then just run the hydraulic pump of the hatch cover. Just pump circulates the hydraulic oil inside, so it is not frozen. The purpose of this one, but normal operation it is closed. Okay, don't forget. So, but no, generally this is, you see, already covered with the anti-corrosive tape and it is stuck up already. If you go to cold climate, don't forget this one. And also it is actually big business. Okay, so if you go to shipyard, because if you cannot take this one out, because in the hydraulic line, generally fitters and the chief engineers don't want to touch. And I am agree with this one. If it is not compulsory, okay. If it is not an emergency situation, something, don't touch the hydraulic line of the hatch cover. I agree with them, but okay, you cannot make this one. So it is better to make in the shipyard. Okay, if you need to change this valve, because if any problem, if the hydraulic line is wasted when you try to open, if it is broken, so in the shipyard they can easily make this one, it will be no problem. Okay. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. I speak too much. You see, pardon. Pardon. Here, you see, this is a firebox. The backside is vested. Okay. Also check this one. These things you check. Okay. You see, here is already vested. Too much rust. Yeah. This is. Cargo hold hydraulic piston upper lower pin already broken, but I have already make this video about this one. I have already make one video. So this is the bobby hatch of the hatch covers. Okay, I have already explained in previous shipyard recommendations videos. If you tighten too much, you will damage the packing. This is the proof of the damaging. You see. You can put your finger inside. Very very big set here. So too much tightening is not good, my friend. Don't forget. You see. Şimdi it is the pin is broken here. And then when we are opening hatch cover, one of the piston just little going down. Okay. So I realize this one. What is this? And then we just clean inside. Put and put some böyle metal wire and then we just check it is the pin of the piston from the down is already broken, so we just put some metal here to support from down when we open until the shipyard. Okay. So if you have to check the pins, also the hatch cover pistons. You see here, this main pin is broken. When we are opening the hatch cover, piston is just little going down. Piston touching this foundation from here also, but we just also support from there. Okay. It is important. Also shipyard, when you deliver new vessel, okay. These repeaters console in the bridge wings. These are the platform itself may be shifted just little, okay. So when you take the true bearing will be okay, because if the repeater same with the gyro compass, it is okay. But the relative bearing will be shifted, don't forget. After new delivery, you have to check this bridge wing. Also the in the middle, the in the in front of the window, inside the wheelhouse, okay. The repeater console itself may be shifted, okay. I already explained here. You know, normally it has to be exactly forward aft direction. But the console itself shifted from the down, okay. So relative bearings will be wrong, but the true bearings will be correct. Don't forget this one, okay. The distance has to be same, yes, between the repeater. What is the distance from the bridge side? You send one guy here, also the same distance, so you can adjust the console of the compass repeater here. Also, this is the middle repeater console. This is the navigational panel. Here is a small corridor. When you are walking, sometimes hit. When you hit, this is also just shifts. Okay, it is important. When you take relative bearing from any fishing boat, anything, any vessel, it will be. You see this console completely shift. Yes, this is another remark from the, pardon. Another remark from the, what was the name? The class surveyor. Okay, so the holding are missing. Okay, so when you see, when you look, you have to see. Okay, don't forget. Yeah, this is another, this has to be, anyway, also one ladder missing here. So when you look and see any problem in the shipyard, especially for the new delivery, you just tell them to make it, okay. You see, I was talking about the air vents. This is air vent, but from inside one of the tank, okay. So sometimes they forgot to remove the top here, the cover. There is a small cover from the factory coming. It is just spot welding. You can remove this one, okay. So sometimes it is forgotten to remove in the new delivery vessels. Don't forget to check. Otherwise when you overflow, water will not come, okay. Başka neler varmış? Yes, here. What is this? Yes, my friend. This is the compass deck, and this is the whistles wire. Okay, this pipe, protection pipe, has to be. It is better if you make yellow, black, yellow, black. Also, what I recommend, the compass deck paint with white color. Okay, it will reduce the temperature of the wheelhouse, maybe 2 degrees something. Okay, so compass deck, paint to white, and this one, the pipes of the wire of the whistle, you paint yellow, black, something like this you can make. Yes. You see, this is a fixed stopper of one of the vessel. It is already cracked. Şimdi don't forget, don't think like this. Sometimes the shipyards can make also mistake. In my last contract as a second mate, okay, I work in a capsize vessel. In that capsized vessel, the hatch covers was cider olur. Yani side opening, not the like this. It was side opening, the hatch covers. And the shipyard fixed this, you know, FX stoppers and FY stoppers. Two kind of stoppers for the hatch covers. So one of them prevent moving to port and starboard, and one of them prevent moving for the forward and aft. So they just make a mistake. They put FX stoppers instead of FY stoppers. They put FY stoppers instead of FX stoppers. They just make a very big mistake. So when you close edge covers, open close, it is just broken the stoppers. Okay, very very big problem. So as much as possible check. Don't forget. Okay. Check everything. Whatever you can check, check in the new ship delivery. Don't forget. Okay. The shipyard itself make a very very big mistake. If I don't know, maybe I think they are not making now like this the David Lunch lifeboat. All of them now new generation of free fall lifeboat. But this David Lunch for the bad weather, for the rough seas, has to be some additional wire tackles. Okay, two set of wire. With this two set of wire, you can pick up this one in very wavy condition of the sea. Otherwise, this parts in the rough sea, while the lifeboat moving too much at the sea, very very difficult to connect here forward and aft at the same time. Very very big problem. But with that additional lines, two set of line, one line wire rope. You connect here already. One of them you connect here, okay. You lower this one, David, to sea level. You just at first connect the wire to lifeboat. You pick up and then you connect other wire here. Remove the long one. And then directly connect this David hook here. And then take the parking position. Has to be one set like this. Don't forget this one. If it is missing, in case of rough motors, because why you will lower this one in bad weather condition? Because most probably starboard side of your lifeboat will be your rescue boat. Okay, so in one time we experienced like this. We were going to United States when we were going to California about one, yes, 5 days distance, something like this. In the Pacific Ocean, we saw one of the small boat, 13 meter boat. Okay. We make announcement, something, nobody reply. We just check the binoculars and then nobody inside. Okay. We just call the Coast Guard. Okay. They order us make rescue. Okay. We just make a rescue operation. So, and the too much swell on the ocean. So, or starboard side lifeboat was rescue boat. We lower this lifeboat. Okay, we go. Nobody inside. Everybody gone. Okay, we take photos. We take the journal, something. We take all the evidences as much as possible. And then when we are taking this lifeboat, it was very, very difficult. Okay, so has to be some set of wire ropes, extra set. For bad weather pickup. Don't forget this one. Okay. Yes. Yeah, it is almost 1 hour, my friend. I stop here. Okay. And then we continue with the next video. Thank you.